Network, Dick McDick coming to you from Saskatchewan here today with an episode of Eye on Tuffnell. I got a lot of you messaging me out there. You're like, Tuffnell, Parkerview, Sheehoe, Laco, Edfield, Burtdale, Margo. These sound like made up places, Quick Dick. Well, not only has Quick Dick not mentioned Elfrost, Leslie, West Bend, and Kuroki, but Tuffnell is a real place. That's why today we're going to go deep into the loins of Tuffnell and see what it's all about. Tuffnell was first established in 1907 by a man named John R. Tuffnell, who was trying to make his way to Saskatoon from Guelph, Ontario with a team of horses and a wagon. After losing the lead mare and his right front wheel on the wagon, John R. Tuffnell said, you know what, I've had enough of this shit, let's just set up shop here, and Tuffnell was born. Just north of Tuffnell, you will find the Gowdy Express, also referred to as Dunlop Road. This is used by local farmers to transport products between Foam Lake, Tuffnell, Sheehoe, and Invermay, who are not interested in adhering to Saskatchewan transportation legislation. The Gowdy Express, or Dunlop Road, runs adjacent to Highway 16, only a mile to the north, making it legal for grid road rules instead of paved road rules. Grid road rules. Lights, driver's licenses, and seatbelts are not required. Weights and dimensions are something that's a made-up thing that you've never heard of before. And slow down when you're meeting the neighbors so you don't put a rock through their brand new windshield. Fun fact about Tuffnell. Tuffnell is home to the Tuffnell Fiddle Camp, where their motto is, come on down and fiddle with your stick. Tuffnell is also home to pivotal businesses in the area, including Big Mustache Adventures that specializes in the hardest of wood for your satisfaction. Tuffnell is also responsible for producing Olympic-quality curling athletes here at the Tuffnell Curling Rink. Ice is natural and volunteer-made. This week's Bonsville has been canceled due to warm weather outside and the roof is just dripping too damn much. Tuffnell Curling Rink is also home to a Peg Mac meal. It's not listed on the board, so you need to know to ask for it. It is a double cheeseburger, onions, deep-fried pierogies, and sour cream made by none other than Peggy McLean. Children that grow up in Tuffnell can get away with absolutely nothing because in the absence of their parents, the neighbors are allowed to discipline them. Tuffnell is a very welcoming community. Unfortunately, if you come to visit and do not pay taxes in the town, you are required to walk because road maintenance is highly expensive. Unless you make a donation to the Tuffnell Curling Rink, then you can drive in. Behind Quick Dick, you can see the site of the last remaining elevator of Tuffnell, which was torn down in 1992, displacing 300 pigeons, 4 badgers, and 2 fox from their home. This also marked a significant date when it is the only time that the army had to be called into Tuffnell due to farmers battling over who would get the leftover 2x4s to fix their chicken coops. Another pivotal day in Tuffnell's history is when they decided to put up street signs in 1963, naming all of the 3 streets that exist in Tuffnell. Along with the Tuffnell Fiddle Camp, Tuffnell is home to the Tuffnell Circle Jammers, where you can come down to the community hall and jam with community members. This raised 2 problems in the past. Due to a typo on a Facebook ad for the Circle Jam, several people showed up expecting something different that you do in a circle. It was quite awkward until they learned how to play something other than their own instrument. Another close call experienced by the Tuffnell Circle Jammers is when many ladies from the community showed up with canners, jars, and pectin hoping to make jam. The day was saved when they left knowing how to play the juice harp and the hurdy-gurdy. The last known shop in Tuffnell was located on the corner of Griggs and Railway and closed in 1963, but if you break down on Tuffnell, people will still come out with their Canadian Tire socket sets and help you try to fix the problem. If they cannot help you get your vehicle fixed, they can offer you a cold beer and a bite to eat while you wait for a tow truck. Or if you live close enough, they will simply hook onto you and give you a Saskatchewan yank back to your dirt floor shop. Not only is the Tuffnell Community Hall home to the Tuffnell Fiddle Camp, the Tuffnell Circle Jammers, and Tuffnell Coffee Row, it is also home to many weddings and dances. It is also home to the Tuffnell Post Office. And although some people may doubt the security of the Tuffnell Post Office, we go by the honor system, whereas if you touch somebody's bill, you are responsible for paying it. Tuffnell is also home of the Tuffnell Sports Day, which happens every long weekend, which holds a Guinness World Record for having the least amount of teams and the most amount of beer consumed at one time. It also holds the world record for having the most injuries sustained at a slow pitch tournament, none of which involve slow pitch playing, most of which involve trying to get in and out of the beer gardens. This concludes our episode of Eye on Tuffnell. Until next time, this is Quick Dick McDick signing off, reminding you that nothing gets a small town rumor going like standing at the window with your pecker showing. We'll catch you next time.